I'm gonna stay awake for the next 50 hours straight.
I've been dreading this moment, but this is gonna be the last time that I sleep for the next 50 hours. I'm gonna freaking enjoy this. All right, the challenge officially starts now.
As you can expect, the start of the challenge was a breeze. I just went with my usual day and then went to go watch the sunset.
I feel like the nighttime is starting and it's about to get much, much harder.
Hey, we were at 12 hours in. So this is where the challenge actually begins. I'm gonna be staying here at WeWork the entire night. Maybe I'll work, I'll do something else. I'm not gonna get tired. The lights are always on, super bright. But if I go home, I would usually be just finishing up a meal and have some magnesium ready. I'd put my phone away. I'd meditate in my cold, dark cave and just collapse asleep. Yeah, at this moment, I'm questioning all of my life decisions. Don't be like me. This is stupid.
But what if you don't want that? And you actually want to get the best sleep of your life and be on top of your game? I've scoured the entire earth and found 3 secrets to get amazing sleep. And I have a feeling they're not gonna be what you expected.
Hour 17. Okay, so it's now like 2 a.m. Everything's going pretty good, but the only thing is I'm getting a little bit bored. I'm part of this gym that's open 24/7, so I'm thinking, why not go over there?
Let's get this party started. At this point, I was feeling great. I had a ton of energy, started doing a little bit of exercise and stretching, and I was thinking maybe this challenge was gonna be way easier than I thought.
It's finally starting to hit me. I'm slowly getting tired. It's like 4:30 in the morning. I'm just kinda waiting for the sunrise.
What are the real secrets to get amazing sleep? The first thing I've learned is from Dr. Andrew Huberman, and the tip that he gives is a freaking game changer. So about a year ago, I decided to wear blue light blockers all day, every day, because blue light equals crap sleep. So I went out and got $500 worth of blue light blockers, and then after a year of using it every single freaking day, I learned that
blue light is great. A lot of people will say, oh, I should be wearing blue blockers throughout the day. No, if you're going to use blue blockers, that should be reserved for late in the evening.
Ah, okay. Well, why is blue light so important then? See, blue light comes from the sun. It's the only thing that stays constant every single day. It goes up and it goes down. No exception. So as humans, we've evolved to rely on the sun to actually set our internal clocks. See, this light shoots into our eyes and is picked up by brain cells that actually communicate it to our internal clock. That thingy-mabobber then tells the rest of our entire body when to do certain functions. But if you screw it up, it's real bad. But don't worry, I'm gonna tell you how to get it right so you can actually, one, fall asleep better, and two, during the day, actually be more alert. It's super freaking simple. 2 minutes to 10 minutes. We want to get sun into our eyes. Don't look directly at the sun. You can use your peripheral vision, but we want to be getting that when it's at low solar angle in the day. So that means in the morning. Take off your damn sunglasses and go outside, because if you look through any of these things, glass included, it's gonna be 50 times less effective. P.S. Contacts and glasses are completely fine. Luckily, the sun was just about to rise, giving me some hope that I desperately freaking needed at this point. Plus, the sleep deprivation was slowly kicking in. I was getting really freaking weird.
Top of the morning to ya. And we have done it. Half the way there, basically.
Yeah, so the coffee didn't work. So I needed something stronger. And at that moment, I instantly entered the deepest meditative state of my entire existence. I was one with the world.
Nope. Alright. Definitely feeling more energized now. I usually do these cold baths every morning, but I don't add ice, so it was like a freaking shock to my system. So much better than cold showers, by the way, because you have the option to turn it hot. But when you're in an ice bath, you can't switch it to hot. It doesn't work like that. And you don't want to waste the water. You want to use it.
With this newfound energy, I was feeling adventurous. So I met up with a friend, Shervin, and we went to another WeWork. I then mindlessly did some more video editing, and then went to Nate O'Brien's meetup in Washington Square Park. And somehow, I was still able to form sentences at this point. At least, I think I was. And after that fun experience, it was on to the final night.
So right here, I've got the strongest frickin' coffee in the entire world. It's literally brewed in the fiery depths of hell. And I'm gonna start off with their cold brew. It's got frickin' 300 milligrams of caffeine. And there's two other ones that I'm gonna pace myself throughout the night. This is the final stretch. We are at hour 36. And oh my god, I cannot wait to frickin' be done with this. I feel drunk. I don't even feel like me. I need this caffeine, cause I don't know. Man, I miss sleep so much. This is just making me feel so grateful for the opportunity and gift that I get every single bloody night to go to bed. It's like, it's so interesting. Humans are like the only mammals that willingly decide to get less hours of sleep. But once you start getting enough sleep, man, you just start feeling like a freaking superhero instead of like literally just feeling like crap or like a subpar version.
Hour 37.
Oh man, I'm starting to feel it in my eyes. They're getting really freaking heavy. I'm just basically distracting myself by watching YouTube and Netflix. It's time for the next coffee.
But before we do that, what's the second secret to get amazing sleep? Over the years, I've seen a lot of people subscribe to the idea of hustle culture, telling me that they'll sleep when they're dead. So they work late, hoping that more work equals more success in their life. Finally fall asleep to get 5 to 6 hours of crappy sleep, wake up feeling groggy, all to do the exact same thing the next day, and the next. All until they finally get completely burnt out. See, the thing is,
nobody really works 80 to 120 hours a week sustained at high output with mental clarity. Your brain breaks down. You just won't have good ideas.
Don't believe me? Listen to the man, the myth, the legend, Naval. So then what should we do to live a more balanced life and give our body the rest that it needs? We can do this by practicing NSDR, non-sleep, deep rest, during the day and actually before going to bed. Meditation, sleep hypnosis, yoga nidra. There's a bunch of different ways. I'll link a bunch down below. It's gonna basically train your body to get really freaking good at switching between hyper alert productive mode into rest and chill and I wanna go the heck to bed mode. So by doing this, you're just gonna basically be able to fall asleep way bloody faster.
Time for the strongest actual cup of filter coffee in the world. It's supposed to be like 2 times stronger than the average cup of coffee.
I really freaking need this right now. My eyes are just starting to fucking shut. Oh my god, so much caffeine. Pretty good coffee though. I'm happy. It's really interesting branding. Like, I don't know how you don't look at the branding and go like, fuck, I'm gonna die. I had friends literally asking me like, yo, you good? You sure you're not gonna overdose on caffeine?
And the very last thing I could find from this company, Death Wish, they have chocolate-covered coffee beans. Pretty good. And I hope this goes without being said. Please, do not be a dummy like me and stay up this long and have this much coffee. Get your sleep, please, I beg of you.
These last 10 hours got really, like I'm talking really weird. I started doing anything to stay awake. I had a dance party, I started slapping myself in the face, I did sprints up and down the hallway, and created a masterpiece. Some might say is prettier than the Mona Lisa. It was getting way, way harder. The anticipation was starting to build up. I was contemplating whether I was gonna die or not. I was getting so bloody cold. The finish line was so close that I literally almost fell asleep in my chair while watching Netflix. But I stayed determined, and this finally happened.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, yeah! Oh, thank God I can finally go to freaking bed.
And immediately I fell asleep and had 16 hours of beauty sleep. But what if you can't fall asleep as fast as I did? And that's where the third secret comes into the rescue. I learned that we have to stop taking our phones into our beds at nighttime and doom scrolling for hours on end. Set a recurring alarm 1 hour before bed. Whenever it goes off, immediately chuck your phone into your closet or out of sight, charge it for the night, and you're not allowed to touch it anymore. But the thing is, these three sleep tips are helpful, but alone are not going to give you amazing sleep. There's actually one more thing that you have to combine with it if you really want long-lasting change. And in this video here, I'll show you exactly what that is and how after wearing this advanced sleep tracker, I was able to start getting the best sleep of my life. So don't ignore this if you really want to make progress.